Ever wondered how we can use electricity from a battery or solar panel to power our home appliances? Well, that's the magic of an inverter. In this video, we are going to break it down in the simplest way possible. Let's get started. First things first, what exactly is an inverter? An inverter is a device that takes direct current or DC power, the kind you get from a battery, and converts it into alternating current or AC power, which is what most of your home appliances use. Think of it as a translator between two different types of electricity. Now you might ask, why do we even need this conversion? Well, appliances like your fridge, TV, and washing machine are all designed to work with AC power. But batteries and solar panels give us DC power. So, the inverter is like the middleman that makes everything compatible. Alright, let's dive into how an inverter works. The process is actually pretty straightforward, and here's the simple version. First, the inverter takes DC power from a battery or solar panel. Then, it rapidly switches the direction of the current to mimic the back and forth pattern of AC. This switched signal is then boosted to a higher voltage, like 220 volts, through a transformer. Finally, it's output as clean AC power, ready to run your appliances. This is the simplified overview of how an inverter works. Now, let's take a peek inside an inverter and the key components that make all this magic happen. Battery. This is the power source that provides the DC electricity. And inside inverter, we have oscillator circuit, control circuit, and a transformer to convert the DC power source from battery into AC. The oscillator circuit is actually the heartbeat of the inverter. It's responsible for creating the wave pattern that simulates AC power. The oscillator circuit rapidly switches the DC current on and off. This switching is done using components like transistors or MOSFETs. By controlling switching speed, the circuit generates an oscillating signal. Capacitors and resistors may also perform a role in the circuit to shape and stabilize this wave pattern, ensuring it closely mimics a real AC sine wave. This wave is crucial because it determines how well the inverter can power different types of appliances. Control circuit. This is the brain of the inverter. It manages the switching to ensure the output is smooth and stable. The transformer boosts the voltage to the level needed for your appliances. And finally, you get the desired AC output for your household appliances. But not all inverters are created equal. The type of wave they produce affects what they can power. Based on the type of output wave they produce, the inverters are classified into square wave inverter, modified sine wave inverter, and pure sine wave inverter. Square wave inverter. This is the simplest and cheapest type, but it's not suitable for sensitive devices. These waves can damage or disrupt the operation of sensitive devices like medical equipment, audio systems, and precision electronics. Modified sine wave inverter is better than square wave and good for most devices, but it can cause a buzzing sound in some appliances. This might be a better choice for the places where the usage of general appliances is more. Pure sine wave inverter is the best type. It's perfect for all appliances, especially sensitive ones like computers and medical devices. So why should you care about all this? If you're setting up solar power or a backup power system, knowing how inverters work helps you choose the right one and use it efficiently. Plus, a little knowledge always goes a long way, right? And that's it. Now you know what an inverter does, how it works, and what's inside it. We hope this video made the topic super clear for you. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more such simple explanations. See you next time!